Okay, this is Abby's new bench. It's at the elephant compound. And that's her mama sitting there. Deidre. Can I get to her? And this is the inscription on her bench this time. Abby Albrecht, an elephant never forgets, and neither shall we. And we never will, honey bun. But she has a good view from here. Got an elephant over there. And more importantly, we got elephants over here. That's the mama and the new one. And it's in the shade, nice and breezy. She's trying to throw water at us, apparently. That's okay. It's when I first brought Abby here, she was about 5, and she met Judy. Judy has since passed away. But when she met her, there's an interesting story that goes along with it. Judy kind of raised up her trunk like she was saluting. And Abby asked me why she was doing that, and I said, well, it's because she recognizes you. And she goes, what do you mean? And I told her, I says, well, about a month before you were born in the Chauvet Pont d'Arc cave in France, archaeologists discovered some paintings on the walls, and in one of them there was a small girl child holding a bouquet of 65 roses, and a line of elephants were in front of her, facing her, and the one in the lead was raising its trunk like it was saluting her. And I said, so they're not sure what that means, but I can tell you what it means. It means that Judy recognizes you. And she says, well, what do you mean she recognizes me? Well, you're the girl with the 65 roses. And of course, anybody that knows anything about 65 roses knows that a little 5-year-old boy coined the phrase 65 roses because he couldn't pronounce cystic fibrosis. So there you go. Anyway, this is the view from Abby's bench at the elephant compound. And there's one of the elephants. All right. Love you, Abby. I miss you. And I'll see you later. Bye-bye.